your PFF player profile. Today it's all about Aaron Donald, who secures the number one spot in the PFF 50 for the second straight year, Mike. The best player in the NFL, we said it's regardless of position, doesn't matter. Donald performs his job better than anybody else in the league.
Yeah, I don't think it's really even close. Also, he rolls in to the Rams last season for week two, missed all of training camp because of his contract holdout, comes in week two and is the best player on the football field week in and week out for the rest of the season. 14 games in the regular season last year, and he had more pressures than anyone else in football. A defensive tackle, mind you. So much harder to get pressure on the interior. He still led the NFL.
Well, let's check out the recent career grades when it comes to Aaron Donald, the recent season grades, because we thought that J.J. Watt was a generational talent, and he still kind of was. I mean, J.J. Watt, at his prime, I mean, he was unbelievable. But we thought that Watt was going to completely break the PFF system and that we would never see somebody grade up in that 98-99 range. The best grades we've given since 2006, it's Aaron Donald last year in 2017, but he's also third and fourth on the list 2015 and 2016, three straight years of just unbelievable dominance from Donald.
Well, the thing about Donald, when you look at his pressure numbers in relation to someone like J.J. Watt, Watt's playing kind of on the interior, but he's playing three tech and then outwards. He's also playing on the edge. Donald's playing three tech and inwards. He's playing over the guards sometimes. He's playing over the center sometimes. And it's a lot tougher there. You get a lot more double teams on the interior. You're fighting through a lot more trash than you are on the edge. And yet he's still putting up numbers that we're not even seeing from edge guys.
There's some plays where he beats the guard so quickly, the center or the tackle that's supposed to help can't even get there in time. That's what I love, because it looks great on the chalkboard, but Aaron Donald just breaks the chalkboard because he's so good and so quick. That 91 pressures that you mentioned, though, it is really significant because it led the NFL in just 14 games, as you mentioned, but he beat edge defenders, too. He beat those guys that actually get more pressure per snap on average than those interior defensive linemen. So the fact that he led the league with those 91 pressures, just in the regular season, mind you, in the 14 games at a position that's not supposed to lead, all the more incredible when it comes to Donald's production.
Well, I think the one stat that really sums up how much better he is than every other defensive tackle in the NFL is the fact that he had eight games last year where he had eight or more pressures. The rest of the NFL combined, the rest of the defensive tackles in the NFL combined had only six.
Unreal.
So he's just on another level than not just the next best, but every single defensive tackle in the league, he's dominating.
So we had those 91 pressures in the regular season. They had one playoff game. Yes, they lost the Atlanta Falcons, but he had 11 pressures. He did his part. He was in Matt Ryan's face the entire time. And, you know, when it comes to just the three-year production, as we mentioned before, he's been the guy. The most pressures on the interior defensive line by a significant margin, 252 pressures since 2015. Next closest is Geno Atkins with 229. And then 184 for Fletcher Cox. I mean, he's really – Fletcher Cox is an unbelievable NFL player, a guy that's graded – in the 90s, two out of the last three seasons, and Aaron Donald makes his numbers, I mean, just, it's not even in the same ballpark.
It's almost comedic going back and looking at the scouting reports of him coming out. People questioning, oh, can he hold up at the NFL level because of his size? Is he going to be able to, you know, eat up double teams? And not that run defense really matters, but when you watch him on film against run defense, he doesn't get moved off the ball against double teams. He holds up fantastically. He makes plays in the run game as well. He's not just a pure pass rusher, despite the numbers and his pass rushing ability being off the charts. He can do it in the run game as well. There really is not any knocks to his game.
Yeah, and when he was playing more of the traditional defensive tackle role, he was a top five guy in run stop percentage, so he knows how to finish plays. And like you mentioned, I mean, he wouldn't be grading this high if he was a poor run defender. He is a disruptor in the run game. He's going to beat blocks in the run game and set other guys up. Every now and again, he'll get caught upfield. I mean, that's the one potential
negative.
It's
aggressive. It's an aggressive defense. And you take some of those bad plays for what all he can do and the good.
Yeah, so I think we've laid out a strong case. Aaron Donald, the best player in the NFL. It's the second year running. He's been number one in the PFF 50. Be sure to check out the entire 50 on our YouTube channel. Aaron Donald, the best player in the NFL.